leader of the Obama campaign in Florida, Congressman Robert Wexler. One morning last August, I was sitting in a meeting in my county commission office when my aide stuck his head in and interrupted the meeting. Everyone I was talking to turned to the open door to listen to what my aide had to say. He said, "Commissioner, there is a Senator Obama on the phone for you." Well, just like the movies, all three people in my office slowly turned their heads back to me. Their jaws fell open. I waited a few seconds and then I said, "Tell him I'll call him back." Well, not really. I actually did take his call, and that call has provided me the most incredible opportunity of my life. Thank you. Senator Obama asked me that morning if I would host a reception for him in August. He really didn't know too many folks here in Broward County, and so I agreed to host the reception. I was a little curious about this guy with 2% of the vote running against a group of better-known Democrats. I have to tell you that trying to raise money and generate interest on a Saturday morning in August for some guy named Barack was a challenge. But we managed to pull it off, and it was right after we spoke that morning that I knew I had just met someone special. Here was a man who could lead this nation back from the 8-year disaster that had been. When I got off the plane, it was 4 degrees. We spent a week in the snow at a place called Laconia, along with volunteers from New Hampshire and young people from all over the country. We knocked on doors, made signs, and told voters why Barack Obama was the right choice for New Hampshire. From there, we were sent to Minneapolis. I actually think that the folks in the national office in Chicago who coordinate the volunteer visits kind of scratch their heads and chuckle as they assign Floridians to places with an average daily temperature of 20 degrees. It was there in Minneapolis that we saw what the message of hope was all about. On the Saturday before the Minnesota primary, along with 100 volunteers at 9 o'clock in the morning, we walked into the Target Center, an arena just like this one. We looked up at all the empty seats and wondered how we would ever fill it. Well, several hours later, that arena was filled with people, young and old, black, white, Hispanic, Native, and Asian Americans, all wanting to believe again in the future of this country. And there to support the one man that could bring hope to their lives and hope to this country, Barack Obama. As Barack was introduced by the 90-year-old widow of former governor of Minnesota, a governor who had placed in nomination the name of John F. Kennedy to be President of the United States at the Democratic Convention in 1960. That moment and that meeting was not lost on me or any of the 20,000 people in the Target Center that day. Last month, my husband and I had a chance to meet the other Obama, Michelle. Woman. She brings wisdom and a passion for this country and its families that we will all be proud of. I know you feel the same, but I really like the idea of this woman being in the White House. Today, right here in Broward County, every one of us has the chance to bring change to this country and to return hope to lives. Florida today.